Hey you, welcome in this video, I'm Agelos and today I'd like to share with you a fantastic game played between MVL, Maxime Lagrave, against Aronian. MVL played with white pieces, as you can see in the picture, and Aronian played with black pieces. This game played in FIDE Cup, and this particular game was in quarter-final. So it's black's turn here and it's your move. What are you going to play here with black? It's black's turn. And first of all, you can see that our knight on c5 is under attack, so we may do something with the knight, right? And the most obvious move is to capture with a knight on d3. Yes, everyone will play that move. However, after some thought, you may consider the other move, queen takes on d3, because if we capture on d3 and white capture, for example, on c5, then we can capture the rook on f1 and we can win material. So the position is complicated and you may like to pause the video and think by yourself. We will going to see the game from the beginning, and this game is e4, e5, knight f3, knight f6, bishop c4, the Italian game. Recently, I'd like to mention that we created a new chess course with international master Asaf Givon. He is a guest author on Remote Chess Academy, and he created a fantastic course about positional sacrifices. And during this game, you will going to see a fantastic positional sacrifice by Aronian, and the positional sacrifices can turn the game around. So here black played knight f6, this is two knight defense, and now white have a lot of options. One of them is to play this two knight defense with this move, knight to g5. It is a very complicated and exciting game. After that, white can choose another move, d4, this is another cool gambit, but in top level games, safety is first, and players would like to play safely first of all, don't miss any tactic, or they don't like to go in very very complicated lines, and for that reason they are choosing quiet lines. And this is the reason behind this very solid system, Gioco Pianissimo. d3, bishop c5, c3, as you can see, and you can see white are very solid in the center. a6, a very nice move, because we give little more freedom to our bishop. And we would like to play this move, knight a5, smart castling. Black cannot do this move right now. He would like to play this move, but they cannot do it tactically because the pawn on e5 is unprotected. So d6, and right now black is threatening to capture this powerful bishop on c4. For that reason, white played a4 in order to grab more space and free the diagonal, the bishop diagonal. So if black dare to play there on a5, so the bishop can retreat on a2. Short castle, rook e1, bishop a7. This is a very nice prophylactic move, because sooner or later white will play d4 in order to strike the center, and similarly he can take space from the other side of the board with this move b4. You may consider here another move, for example knight to g4, but this is not very good because black is attacking very rapidly without developing the rest of his pieces, and for that reason such attacks will never succeed. And here white have a very solid move, rook e2, and he can protect the pawn, and after that he will kick away the knight from g4 with this move shown by red arrow with h3, and it's not good for black to capture the two pieces, for example to capture here on f2 and capture the rook, because as you can see black have the rooks, but he cannot play actively with the rooks. We don't have any open lines and the light pieces are more powerful here. For that reason, Aronian played this prophylactic move, bishop a7. Prophylaxis is a very deep idea in chess, and with simple words it's like to clean your teeth. You should do it before face some problems with your teeth, so it's something like that. And this is prophylactic move. Similarly, h3 is another prophylactic move, h6 is another prophylactic move, not to allow bishop to g4. And as you can see, players not only develop his pieces, but similarly they are trying to prevent the opponent's active move. So knight b2 d2, a very nice maneuver in order to go on f1 and develop a kingside attack. Rook e8, another move in order to develop the c8 bishop on e3, b4, grabbing more space, bishop e6, bishop takes e6, rook takes e6, knight f1, queen d7, and now we have this good position. And here we are, the game start to warm up, and you may imagine that white will do something very aggressively with g4, knight to g3, knight f5. Sometimes this bishop could be very active in order to sacrifice here on h6, and everything looks really, really interesting for white, right? Even if you don't have this light square bishop, white can create attack here. However, strong players says this safety first, and MVL played this move, bishop to e3. Perhaps you may consider to change the channel here or to stopping the video, but as you seen, Aronian played very creatively. So he captured here first, knight takes e3 in order to control the light squares d5 and f5, and now black said, okay, you are not doing anything in particular, so I will strike in the center. Not only Sicilian, but similarly in Spanish, black would like to play this free move d5. He would like to liberate himself with this move d5 in order to activate his pieces. His knight from c6 is very active because black have ideas at some time, not right now, to play d4 in order to open the center or create a strong square there. So MVL played b5 in order to kick this knight away, knight e7. There is nothing if black capture here on b5 and do this exchange, because now the knight should retreat in any case, and now b7 could be a potential weakness. For example, we can give a check here on a8 and grab this pawn, or white have more space, so it's no need to open the a line right now. And for that reason, Aronian played knight e7, nice move, c4 in order to close the center, d4, knight f5, rook e8, everything is very normal. Knight 3 to h4, the game is very positional, and white here would like to dominate and increase his control over the c5 square. And the game start change here, because Aronian played very creatively, and he chose this move, this very, very nice move, knight to g6. And from this first sign, you can may consider that this is a mistake, because white can capture on g6, f takes g6. However, we can see the coincidence now. After that, the black pawns are doubled. Yes, indeed, we can see that. But white will never have this f5 square, because we are controlling it very, very well. So white should retreat, for example, here on h4. And after that, after this queen f7, we can make the maneuver, as you can see with the green arrow, to play knight h5, knight f4, or as you can see with the red arrow, we can double on the f line and create problems here on f2. So black will have the initiative here, and for that reason MVL is very, he is very strong player, and he didn't capture the knight. Of course, the game continued, g3, knight takes h4, knight takes h4, and now it's the next question for you. Your computer will not going to help you here, because computers are not good in order to provide good plans, and here you need a good plan for black, you know, because you kicked away the knight and you have active pieces or good pieces. The position is about equal, you have equal pawns and pieces, so you have to find something, and you should search in such cases your worst piece. And here you can see that this knight is doing nothing, right? And if you like to play like Aronian, to play strong chess, you should activate this knight, and we should start right now. The first thing is to play here on h7, and after that on g5, in order to attack something. Here on h3 we can attack something, but white can keep it very, very easily. For example, he can play king g2. So we need to find another square for a knight. Can you find a good square for a knight? Oh, if you spot c5, then you are really, really good player. You are extremely good positional player. And how we can go there with a knight? The queen will go on e7, and after that we will play knight d7, knight c5. And here your computer again will tell you that this move is not the best because the knight can attack the queen, etc. But this is fantastic move and you should play like that. If you like to become better player, you should do such moves in order to activate your pieces. And we can learn a lot from this fantastic game. And here white continue with queen c1 in order to play c5, for example, or to exchange queens on a3. So knight d7, black had a very good plan and he played this move, knight d7, queen a3, and of course black is attacking, and for that reason he don't like to exchange pieces. f4, this is another mistake, but what to do when you have bad position, you are start making mistakes, even you are a great player. So it takes f4, black cannot capture here immediately because this knight is hanging. For that reason he played the intermediate move, knight to f5. The queen cannot go away because she should protect the knight, and after queen f8, g takes f4. And here we have another diagram. The position is about equal, but it's a little more complicated. Why? The kingside pawns are broken, white king don't have good shield here around him, the knight is far away from the other pieces, and actually white cannot do anything here, and this is a fantastic knight. You found it some moves before, right? And this knight is pressing this d3 pawn, so black here have a lot of good opportunities. But the question is how to proceed, how can you activate your moves? One of the ideas here is to find the best move that white have, and you should try to eliminate it. Can you find the best piece? If you found knight f5, then you have very, very good understanding. But the question here is how to eliminate this knight, how to kick it away. For example, it's a little danger to play it immediately, and if you give little time to white, for example, I'll give the move again, and if white plays something like that, and if you play this, then white may consider to pin this g pawn and create problems. Or if you do it in any case, this d6 move, and the knight goes back, then white will have another interesting idea to play this f5 in order to break the kingside, the black kingside pawns. And as you can see, we don't have good shield for our king, however we have open lines, so this move is not working. Can you find another way to kick away this knight or to eliminate it? Can you play like Aronian? And he found this brilliant move, rook to f6, and now the thing start became very, very critical for white. What white can do? He cannot move the knight, of course, because if he move the knight, this pawn on f4 is unprotected. He play rook f1 in order to protect the pawn and remove the knight from this dangerous position. And here comes the blow. Can you find the blow? Of course, rook takes f5. He takes f5, rook e3. Can you see now how fantastically placed is this rook on e3? He is attacking h3. This pawn, he's attacking d3, the f pawn are doubled and weak. We have a powerful knight, we have a powerful rook, we need to activate our queen, and everything looks great. And this is all about positional sacrifices. What you should do, you should sacrifice your rook for the enemy piece in order to activate the rest of your pieces. And here white, what to do, he would like to exchange rooks, queen e7 in order to activate the queen, capture on e3, capture on e3, check, king e2, and now black have winning position. And this was a rapid game. Aronian didn't manage to find the best move, but you have the opportunity to play better and strike down MVL. Can you win MVL? Can you find a really good move? And the best move here is knight e4. Why? Because we would like to bring our pieces closer to the enemy king, and if one queen is in one side of the board, the other queen is prevailing. He's thrilled here on the king side, and this queen is without a counterpart. This queen on e3 is without a counterpart, and he can create huge problems to white, because right now black is threatening to give a check here on g3. And what white can do, for example, if he plays rook g1, then we can create another tactic. Can you understand that these pieces are not standing very well? Can we attack it with our knight? Yes, on d3. And how to go on f3? We can go on f3 via d2. So we will play knight d2, and we are threatening here check. We are threatening the pawn. And you can see this queen is totally, completely out of the game. So black is winning here. Aronian played like a human, and he gave a check first of all. The king goes away and he captured the pawn. And here black have very, very good position. Again, very good position, but this is the moment when Aronian lose the control of the game. He didn't manage to find the best move. It's a difficult move, of course, but he didn't manage to find it. And after that, the exchanges, queen b3 in order to bring the queen back in the defense. Okay, this is a normal move. Queen e3, Aronian makes some checks in order to win little time in the clock, and here we have the diagram position again. And when things goes wrong, then your opponent expect to make another mistake, and here Aronian played another mistake. However, you have the opportunity to play better. Can you do something? Your pieces are pinned. Can you unpin them or create another idea? One cool idea is here to give a check, and after king g1 we can play this move, queen c3, and if white captures, then we can recapture with the pawn, and you can see this powerful setup. The knight and the pawn are really powerful, and it's extremely difficult or impossible for white to stop this pawn. So black is winning here. However, we made a mistake. And what is the mistake? To capture here on c3. And if you check the Igor's video to take the mistake, of course you will play here queen b7. And now white have counterplay because the queen is really active. He can bring the queen back in the defense. And similarly, white have other ideas, for example, to play f6, and after that to give a check on c8, another one on c5, f5, yeah, something like that. So black have counterplay, and of course the pawn on c7 is under attack. This is one idea. Another idea is to wait a little bit with this move, king h7, and after this move, queen d1, for example, white is threatening rook f3, and we can play knight f2 in order to break the cooperation of white pieces. We're attacking the queen, and the d pawn is still there. It's really active because this pawn is coordinated with queen and knight, and we can start pushing the pawn. For example, after queen h5, we can play d3, and if white dare to capture here on f7, again the queen is very far away. Can you find the checkmate in two moves? Yes, it is queen takes h3, king g1, and the difficult move is to give the checkmate here on g3. It's not good to give a check on h1 because the king will capture the knight, but from here the queen will attack the king, and this is a checkmate. If you found this checkmate, please accept my congratulations. You are a fantastic mate in two player. So let's go back. Here h5, Aronian play this move. The idea is very obvious, of course, to play h4 and give a check on g3. And as Fischer mentioned, this brilliant American player, chess is time. You have a plan, but your opponent will have another plan. Queen d1, and now the pawn on h5 is under attack. Aronian played here h4, and here it's the winning move for white this time. Can you find the winning move? You have some time, some seconds to find it. Yeah, rook fc, rook f3, and if you spot this move, then you will have the same smile as MVL. And what to do now? The queen is under attack, the knight is under attack, the game didn't last long. Knight b2, a counter blow, and after this, the pawn and the knight was under attack. Knight b2, capture c5 in order to capture the f4 pawn. Of course, white is attacking, capture here in order to protect the pawn, and after the king activation, you can see another problem on h4. This pawn is under attack now. Knight b6 eliminates some pawns, and after all these exchanges we have this diagram again. White is material up, and what are you going to do here with white? It is the final question. Rook takes d6, very good move because the king should capture, king g5, king e7, and in the end game you should create a passed pawn. Can you find a good way? Congratulations. F6, double attack, and after that we will create this passed pawn, and white won the game. This was a great game, and if you like to learn more about positional sacrifices, then you may study the course. You can find the link below the video. Thank you very much. I was Angelos with you, and hopefully I will talk to you again soon. All the best and good luck with your games.